So you've got a Mustang II front suspension and want to put coilovers on it? Today we're going to walk you through how.
Hi everyone, I'm Tim.
And I'm Trevor.
Today we're going to walk you through the Mustang II coilover fitment option. And the term Mustang II is kind of widely used. It can refer to a stock front end off a Mustang II vehicle that's been removed from that vehicle and then grafted into your street rod or your hot rod. And there's also other aftermarket Mustang II front ends where they use that term. There's differences between them, and the important thing is to determine which one you have so you can select the right product.
Yeah, or keep in mind too, maybe you even have a true 74 to 78 Mustang, which was the Mustang II then, and a lot of those front ends got torn off the cars because they did have a lot of inherent advantages to them and features as well. So, you know, as a long short arm design with coil springs, it had a rack and pinion steering and disc brakes as well. So it for the hot rodder market, it was a popular swap that people swap these front ends into just about anything.
Right. Yeah, and well, I guess we'll start with that one first, which would be your stock type front end Mustang II. Now, QA1, we offer a direct fit coilover system for a factory height and 2 inches lower than stock Mustang II front end. And that is gonna mount in the lower shock mount with a through bolt just into your factory control arm. It uses our tapered spring design where the bottom part of the spring sits on the shock on the bottom, and then the top of the spring and top of the shock fit up into the factory spring and shock mount. So if you have a factory Mustang II front end, all the factory components or compatible components, this should be a bolt-in fitment to work from your factory height to about 2 inches lower than factory.
Yeah, so that's gonna be a real easy part swap there, just a direct bolt-in system. But like we mentioned, there's a number of aftermarket Mustang II front ends out there. So in determining the proper fit on a coilover for an aftermarket front end, we definitely have to be aware of some things there. Oftentimes that front end is designed with a little bit different geometry. The shock placement may be different. The ride height that is needed out of it may be quite different than the off-the-shelf Mustang II setup. And for that reason, we often have to take measurements and get weights on the vehicle to determine the appropriate shock and spring setup to get the intended height and ride quality we're looking for. So if you could, Tim, why don't you cover some of the requirements there to get the right setup in an aftermarket suspension?
Sure. So some aftermarket suspensions, they'll still use this type of configuration where they use a tapered spring. The difference can be that they might move the upper shock mount and spring mount. They might move that to get maybe more travel in the shock or maybe a wider range of height adjustment. So if you have that type of spring and shock setup, it's important to get your vehicle sitting at the ride height that you want it to sit at, and then simply pull a measurement from the top shock mount to the bottom shock mount. And you know, we can help you determine what length you need to fit inside that in that mounting configuration. Some other aftermarket Mustang, you know, they still use the term Mustang II as a term, but it really isn't use any Mustang II actual parts. So it's all fabricated aftermarket components. The shock mounting is different. It's just basically a rack and pinion, short long arm type front end. It might use Mustang II spindles and brakes, but they can mount with an eyelet configuration, top and bottom. And you know, that's obviously significantly different than this type of setup. So the Mustang II aftermarket front ends you see with this type of setup, the shock and spring is closer to the wheel. You have a longer travel shock in there usually, and then it uses a smaller 2.5 inch inside diameter spring. And that is similar to fit that, it's similar to like we do with this one. You're just taking your measurement from center of eyelet to center of eyelet with the vehicle sitting on the ground at ride height to determine what length you need. And then of course you have different spring rate options, which we have a way of figuring that out just based off the front end weight of the vehicle.
Potentially, if you've got a really different, you know, style of Mustang II front suspension, we may also ask you to get some measurements off the lower control arm. Oftentimes that will change the lever ratio of that control arm, which then requires a different spring rate for a given front end weight. So yeah, there can be some definite differences between the aftermarket and the stock suspensions there. So yeah, again, key things, shock length at ride height is probably the biggest one. And if you've got a style like this, yeah, we're gonna measure from this center down here up to the mounting surface there. Oftentimes we'll use like a GM based front shock then, and oftentimes these will have a T-bar style lower control arm mount. But what we got then is conversion parts to adapt that lower mount to a more, you know, Mustang II-esque lower mounting system. So,
Yep. And then another thing to note is the through bolt style on the lower control arm. A factory Mustang II is 7/16, and a lot of the aftermarket stuff is half inch in size. So you want to take a close look at that and make sure you get the right bolt size for your lower mount, because too small of a bolt, too big of an eyelet, or you know, other way around, it won't bolt up. So that's also something to note. So just a few things to kind of look at when you're trying to fit your Mustang II coilovers on and select the right product.
So now that we've discussed the various shock lengths needed, the different mounting points, and the different configurations of both the Mustang II front end and aftermarket versions of it, we've got great information available on our website to determine best shock and spring combinations for your particular setup. And as always too, if you got any questions on that process, please reach out to us on our tech line, and we appreciate you watching the video today.